I want to share a story about transitioning your approach to sales. Transitioning it from, say, a more transactional way to a more partnering way of connecting with your clients. And I'm going to look at this story through the prism of someone who maybe goes into a hardware store. And we're going to look at three generations of salespeople and see how each of their different approaches delivers value for the customer. So let's start with generation one. So the generation one salesperson is very responsive to what the customer says they want. So someone comes into the hardware store and says, I want a broom. It's pretty obvious that the salesperson is going to say, hey, you've come to the right place because we've got brooms. Lots of them, big ones and small ones, specialty brooms, low cost ones, and some that might cost a little bit more. They take the customer to the broom section, the customer chooses the broom, and then they show them the way to the cash register. And this is an approach that in fact has a lot of benefits to it. The customer said what they wanted, the salesperson gave them what they wanted, and it was done really, really quickly. So what's wrong with it? So as things evolved in sales and customer relationships, as things got more competitive, something was wrong with version one or generation one. And what was wrong was that the salesperson never really asked a question. In fact, they only ever made statements. So what is different about what a generation two salesperson does? Well, it's really just one thing, which is they ask questions. And maybe the most important question of all to ask in this situation is, what do you need the broom for? And if the customer then says that they need to clean a garage that's getting filled up with leaves and some dirt, then this starts to create a bit more of a story that the salesperson can then make suggestions around. Certainly, firstly, which of the brooms would be most appropriate? Secondly, are there any other ancillary products that they might need to help clean up the pile of dirt or leaves once it's been put in place? How they're going to bag that up and get it into their rubbish bin? They may even ask questions about allergies, whether they might need a face mask or something like that. So in fact, this idea of just asking what do you need it for, learning a bit more about the environment and what they're trying to achieve, opens up the classic cross-sell opportunity. It may even open up a major upsell opportunity. Perhaps there's a higher priced product like a blower vac or something like that, that would be able to do the job as well in a completely different price point. Maybe this basket of products is worth $70, $80. Maybe it's the ability to take the sale up into the $300 mark. So that's how the generation two salesperson expands the quality of the engagement with the customer, increases the revenue that they can earn, but actually creates a lot more value for the customer. So if that's generation two, let's take a look at generation three. And so finally, we come to the third generation of salesperson. That salesperson who is really confident and understands their market. They understand why people want to buy brooms. They also understand that they're not really here to buy a broom. What they really probably want is a clean floor or a clean garage. And so they ask even more questions of the customer to understand the situation better. They might ask questions about where the leaves are coming from, where the dirt is coming from. They may ask questions about how often this is happening, and even questions about how clean they want to make things. It's these kind of questions, coupled with some in-depth knowledge, that helps them produce even insightful questions or indeed an insight. Because there's a little backstory to this, which is if this is a garage, most slabs that the garage floor is laid on have what we call a fall. The fall is there to make sure that any water that might get into that space flows back out again and doesn't end up in the house or in a puddle in the middle. That fall can sometimes leave a gap between the garage roller door and the slab. And it's the gap where leaves and dirt can blow in. Because remember, the garage door is closed most of the time. So by asking this question of the customer, finding out that they do indeed have a gap, the salesperson from generation three has a moment and says, you know what, I want to show you something that I think will help prevent leaves and dirt getting into your garage. You're still going to need to clean up occasionally, but it's going to mean that you're not going to have to do this very much at all. Let me show you in aisle 12, let me show you a weather seal that you can place at the bottom of your garage door to stop the leaves coming in. So that's the difference between generation 3 and generation 2. And a big difference obviously between 2 and 1. But there's a coda to this story that I want to share with you right now. And the coda is that after the salesperson has completed the sale, the sales manager comes over and says, what have you done? You could have sold that customer a blower vac for $320. But what our salesperson, our generation 3 salesperson, knows that perhaps the sales manager doesn't, is that the loyalty of this customer has significantly more value than the revenue from selling them something they don't really need. The lifetime value of this customer, including all the advocacy this customer might do for you, has significantly more value than one big sale. And particularly if that's a product that can be solved by a $13 roll of masking tape.